In this video, I'm going to show you how to start making music on your computer. This includes the hardware and software that you'll need to get started. Plus, I'll show you some of the basics to actually start recording. Welcome to Simple Green Tech. I'm Radio Zane, and on this channel, I do audio tech tips, tutorials, and reviews to help you unleash your creativity. Today, we're going to be looking at how to start making music on your computer. And just so you know, any of the software or hardware that I use or mention in this video will be linked in the description below, as I'm not going to be going into great detail on each piece of hardware or software. So let's jump in. First up, let's look at the hardware needed. You'll need an audio interface to record your voice or your instrument into your computer. And these can come in all shapes and sizes and various price points as well. There are two audio interfaces that I recommend to beginners on a budget. They are the Behringer UM2 and the Behringer UM2. Now, both of these have very similar inputs and outputs. I've actually done a video comparing the two. I'll link to it in the description below, and there should also be a card at the top of the screen right now that you can click on in case you want to check out the differences between the two interfaces. But both of these should give you great quality audio for a beginner. Now, if you need to record two mics at the same time, you might want to look at getting something like the Focusrite 2i2. This gives you two quality mic preamps, plus the inputs can also be switchable between mic inputs or line signals. And you also get some decent plugins included with it. If you have the extra budget that you can spend on an audio interface, I highly recommend looking at the Focusrite 2i2. Now, with your audio interface, you're going to need some quality cables. I use Kirlin brand cables. They're very good quality and they're budget friendly. And if you're going to be using a microphone in your setup, you're going to want to get a female XLR to male XLR cable, not one of those XLR to quarter inch cables. They're not going to give you a good quality sound. And if you need phantom power, you won't be able to get it with one of those cables. All right, so now we have our audio interface and our cables. We're going to need some software to record into. And this recording software is typically called a DAW, D-A-W, or Digital Audio Workstation. And there are several free digital audio workstations available. I've actually done a video of my top 5 picks. There should be a card up here somewhere that you can click on to check it out, or I'll also link to it in the description below. The DAW that I'm going to be using in this video is called Tracktion T7, as this is my personal favorite out of all the free DAWs out there. With our audio interface connected, let's open up Tracktion T7. Now we want to make sure that the software is set to use our audio interface. So we're going to go up to Settings. Click on the Audio Devices tab, and right where it says Audio Device Type, click in here and you want to choose ASIO. For this, I'm going to be using my Focusrite 2i2, so it's already clicked on there. And once this is set for your one, you can create a new project or go into an existing project. And if you're just recording audio to make your music, so maybe you're recording an instrument in your voice and you don't need any virtual instruments, you can actually get started right away. So you'll just take your track and you want to click in this area here, and where it says no input, you want to make sure it's set to the input that you're going to be recording to. So I'm going to be recording to my input 2. I'll click on that. Then you can click on this arm for recording button right here. And once you click on it, you can play on your guitar or in your mic, and you can see that there's some audio going through, which means you can start recording by clicking the record button down here. And any of the tracks that are armed for recording will record when you press this button. And then you can go to the next track, do the same thing, and you can move your clips around the timeline as needed and make your music that way. However, most of us are probably going to want to use some virtual instruments like drums or bass or synthesizer. You can download a ton of free plugins out there. I recommend for drums using MT Power DRUMKIT 2. This is a great free drum instrument. It sounds like real drums because it is real drums that were recorded and sampled into this instrument. Plus, you get some cool grooves with it. And grooves are just drum beats that are already created. And you can easily drag those into the timeline. And now you have a drum beat all ready for you. And you'll notice that the guitar that I recorded earlier is a little plain. It's just electric guitar going straight into my interface. So what we might want to get is a guitar amp simulator. And the one I recommend is AMPLITUBE. They have a free version that you can go to their site and download. I've linked to that in the description as well, so you can check it out. So let's add that here and see what the difference is like. All right, so we have our guitar audio here. We have a drum pattern over here. We may need to draw in some MIDI notes for, say, a bass line. And we'll use track 3 here. And you just want to drag down this red plus sign into track 3 and click on Insert New MIDI Clip. And we have a MIDI clip here. You can drag this around the timeline as needed. And now we're going to want to bring in a synthesizer. So we'll just add new plugin. Now I'm going to use Expand 2. It comes free with a lot of MIDI keyboards, and you can also get it for very cheap on Plugin Boutique. They always have sales on it. So check that out if you're interested in this synthesizer. And we'll select a preset by clicking down here. And we want a bass. So where is our basses? Let's say hard pick bass, why not? Okay. Now we can draw in notes here as we need to. And now we have our bass line of sorts here. Let's hear how it sounds. All right, obviously I was just sort of playing around with this. It's not an actual song that I was putting together. But I'm sure when you sit down and you start creating something, you're going to be creating something great. And I look forward to hearing what it is you do create. Feel free to share that with me in the comments below and let me know what kind of music you're actually creating with this. And you can repeat the recording process or the MIDI process on as many tracks as you need. And you can just adjust them around the timeline as needed for the song. Click this video up here to see my free digital audio workstation picks. And click this one here to see what YouTube recommends you watch next. Thank you so much for watching. Also, subscribe if you'd like to see more videos like this one. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Radio Zane, and we'll talk soon.